Nice. Well, I thought we'd just start recording just to save me getting back up again.
We will.
We're not prepared at all. I know.
No, that's fine. That's the way that we do it, though, isn't it?
Yeah, of course.
Just hit record and see what's going on.
Just dive straight in.
I was absolutely not ready for you to hit record then, I'll be honest.
No. Well, maybe this won't stay. Maybe the viewers won't ever hear this. But
edit point. Get rid of this.
All of it gone.
How you been?
Yeah, good. Since about 30 seconds ago when I last spoke to you.
Yeah, I know, but that wasn't on audio. The intro each other.
How are you
doing, Connor? I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
I'm well.
How are you doing, Joe?
Yeah, very good. Quite hungover today, but other than that, good.
Nice. This will be a hungover episode.
I'm really ready to reload the words.
Yeah.
Understand it fully.
It's a good condition to be in, that's for sure. When you've got to do some intense reading.
Yeah. I'm going to write it down. I'm going to say it now, just so I don't forget it. I do actually have a bit of a Bible news.
Bible news, here we go.
I learned that the heard this on a podcast, of course, that the ritualistic aspect of eating the body of Christ, brackets bread, was brought in like the 11th century.
Way
after Christ.
Yeah.
A bit spoilery.
Yeah, okay.
To even mention that name, I suppose.
Jumping way ahead.
Going way ahead.
Okay.
Heard that, thought it was quite cool.
That is a good Bible stat.
Got any?
I got some Bible news.
Bible news?
I spent a bit of time in a church this weekend, actually.
Nice.
Yeah, doing a little bit of wood carving.
Nice.
A typical church activity.
Yeah.
Or so I imagine. The church in question is going for a refit.
Yeah. Sick. What church is it?
It's the Trinity Church.
Okay.
Also, it's not really a church.
Yeah.
I mean, the building was a church.
It's like a venue, really, isn't it?
Yeah. That's so cool. It's a community. It's a community space now.
Yeah. Cool. How's the refurb doing?
It's going to take a while, I think. Apparently, yeah, they are £200,000 short of the money that they will need to do the refurbishment. So I'm wondering why they're going ahead. That's usually I'd want all the money accounted for before going ahead with a venture, but you know, I know it works differently with churches.
Different strategies.
Yeah.
Different strategies. It's not like we can even help at all, because this episode is going to be quite a few months after the refurb, so
we
can't even ask anyone to help out with that or anything.
And we're not going to donate all the money that we make from the podcast to the church either, even though it would easily cover it.
That paycheck's really nice, isn't it?
It's odd to get it weekly as well when we don't record weekly.
Yeah.
And none of the episodes have gone out yet.
Yeah.
I often think that's weird.
It's really weird.
Yeah.
It's really weird. I do wonder where that check does actually come from.
Yeah. I mean, I did look into the bank that transfers it to you.
Yeah.
They are based in Ghana.
Okay.
But that's as much as I could really see about it.
Is that where iTunes headquarter is? Because
yeah, I think it is.
The check says iTunes. It's spelt weird, but it is iTunes.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So yeah, that's a nice check.
Yeah.
I didn't expect it, to be honest. And like I say, we haven't even released anything yet. So
yeah.
Where the fuck's it coming from? Ghana. Should we? Bibles?
Yeah, we've got a couple of, I don't know if you have heard of them, viewers at home, but there are a couple of holy Bibles in book format.
The holy Bibles.
First time viewers might not have heard of them, of course. I suppose we have got to cater to the first time listener.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people that just sort of like, they'll see a podcast series which has got, you know, like over like 400 episodes or something in the bag, and just jump straight in, just go for a random number. I would want to stress not to do that with our particular podcast, because
you'd miss so much if you've done that. Just
definitely.
Start at the beginning.
Yeah.
go all the way through the podcast of us reading the Bible.
Yeah, so if you're one of those people, go back to the beginning. But for all the other people who have been reading along, obviously you are aware of the book that we've been reading.
Holy Bible.
Yeah, the Holy Bible. You probably know what chapter we're on as well, which I must admit I do not.
Starting now on 22.
Of course.
21.
Yeah, who could forget Genesis 21?
Yeah, who could forget that?
Do we have to... we've got to do a recap then, I suppose, don't we?
Oh yeah, let's recap what happened last time. I have no idea.
No,
I can't remember that.
No.
I can't remember Genesis 21 at all. I think that was like... Yeah, I mean, it is right in front of me. I could have a quick look, I suppose.
Could have a quick, sneaky look back. Of course, we obviously remember every detail, but it's good to be refreshed before you go into something and commit to what you're saying. Yeah, I mean,
even rereading it now, I don't remember that.
It doesn't seem very familiar.
I might have even missed an episode or something, because I do not remember any of that. But today, I'm confident that we've done 21.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah, we'll start on 22. Is that the recap done?
I think that's the recap done for this week. Okay, we're moving straight on. Nice.
I can't recap anything from last time. Do I go in bulks of five again?
Yeah, we'll go in a nice set of five. Right. It gives it a nice flow.
I'm going to start, right?
Okay, here we go.
I'm going to just
jump straight in. Bit of Bibblin. Oh yeah, you've got to read the
Yeah. Right, the Holy Bible, King James Version, 1611 edition.
The whole thing.
The whole bloody thing. The first book of Moses. A book called Genesis. Oh no, the first book of Moses called Genesis 22:1.
That was tough.
And it came to pass after these things that God did it. Oh, bloody hell. I'm going to struggle
I love
so
an
much today.
That starts with me struggling. I don't know how many words in we are there, but that's under 10, I'm sure.
Mate, I'm so hungover. The idea of sitting here and reading the next hour is. I just can't do it. I can't read. This is going to be a weird episode. It's going to be a fucking long episode. Yeah.
Get comfy. Get your favourite armchair. Get your fucking mug of cocoa like at your side. Get the kettle on ready for the next one because we're in it for the long haul. Genesis 22.
Genesis 22:1. And it came to pass after these things that God did tempt Abraham and said unto him, Abraham, and he said, Behold, here I am. It's a bit poetic, isn't it, God? Well, King James.
It's all King James, really.
Yeah.
I would imagine that God would speak in, like, you know, the working tongue. Like.
What, do you reckon he's Cockney?
Yeah.
Do you reckon God's Cockney? I'm really going to struggle with this. Genesis 22:2. And he said, Now thy son, thine only Isaac, whom...
Oh, mate, you missed the word.
Oh, bloody hell. All right, here we go. Genesis 22:2. And he said, Oh, my God. I can't read. I cannot read. Genesis 22:2. And he said, Take now thy son, thine only son, Isaac, whom thou lovest, and get thee into the land of Moriah, and offer him... there for a burnt offering upon one of the mountains which I will tell thee of. Genesis 22:3. And Abraham rose up early in the morning and saddled his ass and took two of his young men with him and Isaac his son and clave the wood for the burnt offering and rose up and went unto the place of which God had told him.
Right, I'm sorry, what's saddling his ass?
Yeah, I don't know.
What is the action to saddle an ass? What would you say it would be?
Saddle an ass? Saddle a donkey.
That could be the literal thing, but it sounds like there's a deeper action there.
What could saddle be? Like, euphemistically?
Yeah. I don't know, just having like a good like counterclockwise rub of your bum cheek, I think, is really...
Or like a Karate Kid style, like wax on, wax off.
Yeah, that's it.
Thing.
Yeah, watch him sit on his ass.
Alright, here we go, reading. Genesis 22:4. Then on the third day, Abraham lifted up his eyes and saw the place afar off. Genesis 22:5, and Abraham said unto his young men, abide ye here with the ass, and I and the lad will go yonder and worship and come again to you.
I think I read that in the Lad Bible, actually.
The Lad Bible?
Yeah.
Abide ye here with the ass, and I will go to the lad and go yonder.
Genesis 22:6. And Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it upon Isaac his son. And he took the fire in his hand and a knife, and they went both of them together. Genesis 22:7. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father and said, my father. And he said, here am I, my son. And he said,
Hang on a minute, you can't just brush past that.
Oh man, it's going to be a harsh episode as well, apparently. Okay. Genesis 22:7. And Isaac spake unto Abraham his father and said, my father. And he said, here I am, my son. And he said, behold the fire and the wood, but where is the lamb for a burnt offering? Genesis 22:8. And Abraham said, my son, God will provide himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them together. Genesis 22:9. And they came to the place which God had told him of, and Abraham built an altar there, and laid the wood in order, and bound Isaac his son, and laid him on the altar upon the wood.
Oh, bloody hell.
That's some classic Abraham right there, though. I swear, he's... How many altars... What's the altar count on Abraham right now?
It's about 16.
16?
It's about 16, yeah.
Yeah, you could do a good drinking game with how many, was it, altars? Yeah.
Well, next time we read the Bible...
Yeah.
Do it as a
second time through. Yeah. Season 2, the Bible. Again.
Imagine if it wasn't any quicker or like get anything more out of it or anything.
No.
Just read it again. Just like da 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 da.
No, we should do is like get the manuscript version of the podcast that we're gonna get.
Yeah.
Like
printed.
Yeah. Us reading that. Us doing the second way through, but we're reading all our own words.
With commentary on that as
well. Commentary on the commentary and on the Bible itself.
Yeah, cool.
That's so meta.
Yeah, we'll do that.
Yeah.
You just got to get through this in a minute. We're currently on page 16.
Yes.
There's fucking loads of pages.
That's just dawned on me as well. Is it still me or is it you?
I don't know where you got to there.
You know what?
You've got to do 22:10.
Okay, yeah. I was kind of hoping that I could do Job 22:10 because I just know it's going to be a screamer of a verse.
Yep.
Here we go, guys. Strap yourselves in. Genesis 22:10. And Abraham stretched forth his hand and took the knife to slay his son.
Bloody hell.
Oof.
Why did he.
Father son murder.
Why did he put him on the bloody altar if he's just going to knife him?
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, no, I suppose it's an offering to Big G.O.D., isn't it?
Yeah, and any excuse to make an altar, really, isn't it?
Yeah, he just loves altars. All right. yeah, that's pretty brutal.
Yeah.
He's not the nicest of chaps, is Abraham. He's done some cool shit, I think.
All I can remember him doing is...
Altering.
Altars, yeah. No, this is the guy that sold his wife's sister.
Okay.
Or tried to. He's the swindler. He rocks around,
swindler.
Starting up little like entrepreneurial businesses.
Yeah.
That he calls altars.
Yeah.
Like.
And then bouncing.
Yeah.
As it falls to shit.
And he sends his fuck man, God, the big G.O.D. in to get like people to fucking pay their debts, to give him like loads of like herdsmen and women and man and women servants.
Yeah. She calves.
She calves. Yeah.
Yeah, he's not very nice, but I'm sure... Well, we'll just keep reading.
Yeah, we'll keep... Stay tuned for more Abraham.
Genesis...
Classic character.
Genesis 22:11. And the angel of the Lord called unto him out of heaven and said, Abraham, Abraham. And he said, here I am.
What?
Genesis 22:12. And he said, lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do hath anything.
Do
unto...
hath? Is that really right there?
Yeah, it's not even hath, is it? Genesis 22:12. And he said, lay not thine hand upon the lad, neither do thou anything unto him. For now I know that thou fearest God, seeing thou hast not withheld thy son, thine only son, from me. Kicking off. Genesis 22:13. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. Abraham went and took the ram and offered him...
I'm sorry, mate, but you missed an and there.
Oh, fuck.
I love those little finicky ones.
I was struggling so much on by his horns.
Yeah, I like the way you drove that home. You sound like an auction seller or something. Like,
I am legitimately struggling to read today. Horns. I can't actually read today. This is every inch of my being is going into this.
Well, I just want to point back to the fact we've only got fuckloads of pages to go.
Yeah, we'll get through it. Genesis 22:13. And Abraham lifted up his eyes and looked, and behold, behind him a ram caught in a thicket by his horns. And Abraham went and took the ram and offered him up for a burnt offering in the stead of his son. Genesis 22:14. And Abraham called the name of that place.
Good luck.
Jehovah Jireh. Yeah, that. Genesis 22:14. And Abraham called the name of that place Jehovah Jireh, as it is said to this day, in the mount of the Lord it shall be seen. Is it still called Jehovah Jireh?
Jehovah Jireh?
Yeah, that's Jehovah, a complicated word. Genesis 22:15. And the angel of the Lord called unto Abraham out of heaven the second time.
Genesis 22:16. And he said, by myself have I sworn, saith the Lord, for because thou hast done this thing and hast not withheld thy son, thine only son. Genesis 22:17. That in blessing I will bless thee, and in multiplying I will multiply thee seed as the stars of the heaven, and as the sand which is upon the seashore. And thy seed shall possess the gate of his enemies. Genesis 22:18. And in thy seed shall all the nations of the earth be blessed, because thou hast obeyed my voice. Genesis 22:19. So Abraham returned unto his young men, and they rose up and went together to Beersheba. And Abraham dwelt at Beersheba. Genesis 22:20. And it came to pass after these things that it was told Abraham, saying, behold, Milcah, she hath also borne children unto brother Nahor.
Genesis 22:21. That is a weird place to put the numbers if you're gonna just like start over. Genesis 22:21. Huz, his firstborn, and Buz, his brother, and Kemuel, the father of Aram. Huz and Buz.
Huz and Buz.
A brother, like, yeah. Like a comedy duo.
That
I
is a brotherly, yeah.
Cousin Buz.
Comedy duo, if ever I heard one.
Yeah, Huz and Buz are really, really underrated.
They're overrated in my estimations. Huz and Buz.
Genesis 22:22. And Chesed, and Hazel, and Phildash, and Jidlaf, and Bethuel. Amazing. We've got a name in episode, I tell you. I
always love these written in episodes.
Genesis 22:23. And Bethuel begat Rebekah. These eight Milcah did bear to Nahor, Abraham's brother. Genesis 22:24. And his concubine, whose name was Reumah, she bare also Teba, and Gaham, and Thashash, and Maacah.
Nicely done.
Oh, and that's Genesis 22 done.
That is it.
What an episode. I didn't think there would be another Amen bit.
Sometimes old Bible...
They just throw it in there.
Yeah, King James, he likes to just slip in those... like just little bits, segments of naming, just like right at the end.
Huzz and Buzz
seats and stuff. So, yeah, like
Huzz and Buzz are fantastic.
We've not even heard of them yet, as well.
No.
That's the first time appearance of Huzz and Buzz.
I reckon that they're going to be a comedy duo.
Yeah.
I think they're going to be the first comedians.
Yeah.
I think that's what's going to happen.
Yeah.
They got names built for it.
Definitely.
Huzz and Buzz, probably.
If we hadn't already settled on a name for this whole project we've got here, Huzz and Buzz's Bible Adventure or something.
That's funny.
It's pretty out there. You really have to listen through until, you know, Genesis 22 to really get that reference. But I think that's kind of funny.
That's actually really good. We'll talk off air about that.
Yeah.
Imagine if this is actually like where you find out.
Yeah. Is it the origins?
Yeah.
Might have become clear.
It's like, who the fuck are Huzz and Buzz?
Yeah, Huzz and Buzz is excellent adventure, man. Huzz and Buzz.
Yeah, that was good. That was a good episode.
Do you think
Genesis 22?
If you were in the band Avenged 70 and Sevenfold,
yeah,
you would have to call yourself Huzz or Buzz, I think. Or
both of them.
Huzz Buzz.
Yeah. Each member of the band has got to change their name by default to Huzz Buzz.
Huzz Buzz. They're all just Huzz Buzz.
Everyone's Huzz Buzz.
Yeah.
You can have like
there are four Huzz Buzzes in the world, and all of them are in one band.
Yeah.
Avenged 70 and Sevenfold.
Yeah.
Nice.
Do you remember what my rap name was? Do you remember that one? There was a really, really funny like name that we found. I can't remember. I'm going to have to listen back through to the podcast.
Yeah, I couldn't even find it if I tried to read through the Bible to both of you.
No, not at all. Look at how small the words are. I'm sure you're following along at home, guys, but there's at least 1,000 bloody words on a page. I mean, that is an absolutely made-up stat.
Yeah.
But
it's true.
There's a lot of words on there. Yeah. I'm not going to count them.
I was thinking, you get those like little Bibles, which are like really small.
Mm.
And like the print is very, very small as well, of course.
Yeah.
But like the paper itself is really thin, so that you can so it's lightweight and you can carry it in your pocket or in your backpack without it really straining your shoulders.
Yeah, like this heavy thing.
This big thing would. Yeah. But what other uses do you think we could come up with for something of that size, like a Bible? Because I mean, it's tracing paper is probably pretty similar to the paper they print on. Like, you know, if you needed to make a quick sketch of a Bible stat that you read on a board or something, like, just use it as tracing paper. I don't think the Bible would be too offended if you did that.
No, that's fine.
Replaced it with more pages or whatever.
Yeah. You've always got to add pages to your books.
Yeah. But I put you in this scenario. You're, like, out in the woods.
Yeah. Got my Bible.
You've got no tools.
A Bible.
You're stranded. Okay, no, the only thing you have is a Bible. You're stranded, you don't have
a
Bible.
I had a panic for a minute there.
of course, Bible. After this project, you're always going to have a Bible on you. Like, for now, it's going to have to be this big chunky fucker.
I keep this with me all the time, everywhere.
Yeah.
It's really heavy. It's really awkward, actually.
Yeah.
I regret making that decision.
Yeah. I mean, I never carry it in a bag. I just always have it just like on my arm, so I always get comments about it. Like,
yeah.
You know.
Do you duct tape it down?
Yeah, just attach it to myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
On the open page that you're.
Yeah, I'd never go further than. Yeah, I just cross out everything else that I've not read yet. Just waiting until we get to that point. Yeah. So, but I like to just walk through town and, you know, just randomly just have a little bit of a quiet reflection time and loudly shout passages.
Are you that guy?
Yeah. Like, I'm one of those guys. There's quite a few of us.
Yeah, I've seen you about.
Yeah, I assume they must just be our listeners.
Yeah, some of them are, definitely.
Yeah.
Yeah, the ones that have found the internet.
Yeah. Yeah, as well as God.
And God.
But yeah, what else could you do with your Bible? You're stranded in the woods here. I'm sure you must be able to make a fire with it. Like, just, you know.
You can just set it on fire.
Yeah.
That'll just make it. That'll make a good fire, won't it?
Yeah, you could probably eat it.
Just set it on fire.
I'm not sure how much nutrients ink and paper has.
I don't think paper's that good for you. I don't think ink's that good for you either.
Okay. You can ward off predators.
Yeah, or throw it at them.
I was thinking more you read out passages to them, but yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, you could throw it at them.
If you confidently read out passages, that'd be cool. Like a bear would instantly know that you're not to be fucked with.
Yeah, that's it.
Because, they'd just see it.
Yeah, and that's the thing with animals. It's all about like, your level of like confidence and emotion as you say something, but then also the the spiritual nature to what it is that you're saying as well.
Yeah, because
those two things are really what get a strong response from any animal creature.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. That's why you never hear of any priests drowning or...
That's true.
Or drowning.
That's true. I've never heard of a priest drowning.
You never heard of a priest drown, and you never heard of a priest getting eaten by a shark.
Both
are,
true.
Yeah, those are two things.
Absolute facts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Those could have been good Bible facts. We should have put those at the beginning. Bible stats.
Bibblers, thanks for listening. Really appreciate it. You've just got through episode
22.
That means you're
22
hours, weeks, or months through the Bible. There's not much to go. Thanks for tuning in. Join us next Wednesday. We're coming back for more.
22 Scottish, that's right.